very bad children. Of four evil parents.
Village, all revenge begins today.
Get a chance to live the good life.
It must be magic.
In a land of fairy tales.
I totally do not blame you for your mother trying to kill my parents and stuff.
You've already seen Descendants.
Yay.
Now we take a look behind the magic.
Welcome to the set of Descendants.
Like a net.
Boom!
The cast tells their story about the making of Disney Channel's movie event of the year.
The number one word that you could use to describe this film would be epic.
From the director of High School Musical.
I love all the songs. And it's a huge part of the film.
Impressive.
I got chills.
It's a story about friends relying on one another.
I choose good, you guys.
That was definitely the best to put all that work in and then see it. And it's like, wow.
To be a part of this story is just unbelievable.
You sound just like your mom.
Thank you.
It's magical. It's incredible.
This is when we show you our world, the world we live in.
Descendants cast so many spells on screen. And behind the scenes, it was just as full of magic.
I just was so excited to see the whole world come to life.
Well, let's get this party started.
Because it's like, how many more elements could we have asked for to play with?
Everything is epic. The songs, the dancing, the costumes.
Everything about it is very special, very spectacular.
Big green screen day.
It's just so big. We were definitely all excited.
It's fantastic. It's the best day of my life.
Amazing scene, everybody. Amazing scene.
We all had such a good time.
Disney Castle.
It totally found that kid in my heart being like, I'm in a Disney movie.
How stunning is that? What?
The stars couldn't help feeling like fans themselves.
When I stepped onto the stage, it was like a fairy tale. And I kept saying, it's like something out of a movie. And I was like, well, duh, Sophia, you're in a movie.
Being forever.
People used to cower at the mention of our names.
So where's Dove? So you go, Jay.
We first meet our villain heroes on their home turf, the grungy Isle of the Lost.
It's basically Alcatraz. It's very, like, rusty buildings and, like, nasty, grimy stuff all over the place. It's very dirty and gross.
They say I'm trouble. They say I'm bad. They say I'm evil. That makes me glad.
My favorite scene's definitely To the Core.
That's it.
Which is the first song that kind of introduces all the villain kids.
Welcome to my wicked world.
Music is a huge part of the movie's magic. And there's no better way to meet the villain kids in their element.
Come on!
Than this.
Run to the core, run to the core.
Run to the core is great. It's like in your face.
The music was so loud. There were all these amazing background artists surrounding us.
It took days of intense rehearsal to get ready.
I was so tired. I was so winded. Man, my legs were like noodles.
It all helped that we were all working together, and it became like a teamwork, and we kind of rely on each other.
The sweat, I think, is giving it another dimension.
Yeah.
Let's do it, guys.
Obviously, all their hard work paid off.
It was like this electric energy. It was just a totally incredible experience.
That was definitely the best to put all that work in and then see it, and it's like, wow, like that looks really, really good. So that's definitely the most rewarding.
You four have been chosen to go to a different school in Auradon.
What?
Stealing candy, man. So disappointing.
It was from a baby.
That's my nasty little girl.
Mal's mom is Maleficent from Sleeping Beauty.
Widely regarded to be the most evil villain of all the Disney classic villains.
It's the deeds, Mal, that make the difference between mean and truly evil.
And so she has instilled a lot of fear in her daughter Mal, just to be evil, which is sort of the villain equivalent of perfect. And she tries day in and day out to prove to her mother that she can be evil like her. Fine, whatever.
I win.
Dove Cameron has been a big Kristen Chenoweth fan her entire life.
I was once like you, my child, slightly insecure.
I remember wearing my big sister's clothes and her boas and looking in the mirror and singing to Wicked.
That's it.
So a duet with her hero was a dream come true.
That's nice.
I read somewhere that they allow dogs in Auradon. That's crazy, right?
I think that's good. Yeah.
I play Carlos.
Carlos is the son of the notorious Cruella de Vil from 101 Dalmatians.
He's mischievous and he's a troublemaker. He's really afraid of his mom.
Carlos.
So he just kind of does what she says and he kind of just obeys.
Well, they're not taking my Carlos because I'd miss him too much.
Really?
Yes. Who would touch up my roots, fluff my fur, and scrape the buttons off my feet?
Cruella's Cruella. She's still really weird and wacky and crazy.
Can you imagine this being your mom? Yikes.
Now recite our mantra.
There's no team and I.
Oh, run along. You're making me tear up.
I play Jay, the son of Mr. Jafar.
Jafar is, of course, the lamp-obsessed antagonist from Aladdin. Jay is a chip off the old block.
I need him to stock the shelves in my store.
What did you score?
Jay's just grown up, like, stealing things. You know, he takes what he wants, kind of a guy. Ooh. Jay and Jafar's relationship is very business-oriented. Like, that's his mentality. That's the father-son relationship. It's like, what'd you give me today?
Dad. I already tried.
Who is the fairest of them all?
Me.
Oh, you. Yes, better.
I play Evie, the daughter of the evil queen from Snow White.
Of the four villain kids, Evie is the one obsessed with living a fairy tale.
Evie is definitely the girly girl of the group.
You look great.
Thank you. And she's really into style and fashion and makeup. A girl just consumed with the fantasy of marrying a prince.
You just find yourself a prince with a big castle and a mother-in-law wing.
In other words, Mom's dream has become Evie's.
And lots of mirrors.
No laughing. Ring pool.
I've wanted to play a Disney princess my entire life, so this role's definitely really cool and different from anything I've ever done before, so. I just got video bombed by the stars of the movie.
Coming up.
So how about a tour?
And then stuff happens, but you might have to tune in to watch that.
You may have to.
More magic from the set of the biggest Disney Channel movie event of the year.
Get ready. We about to set it all up.
The set of Descendants. We're about to shoot our scene. Something, something, something. Something, something, something. Welcome.
For the misfit kids from the Isle of the Lost, Auradon could not be a more different world. Is a magical land, home to a who's who of A-list royalty.
I'm Ben.
Prince Benjamin, soon to be king.
This is Audrey.
Oh, my mom's Aurora.
Sleeping Beauty.
Yeah, I've heard the name.
For audience and cast alike, it was fun to see classic Disney characters brought to life.
I'm Fairy Godmother, Headmistress.
The Fairy Godmother?
Bippity Boppity, you know it.
I'm Snow White, bringing you up the second coverage of who's the fairest of them all.
I'm Snow White. Who are you kidding? She's definitely had work done.
And the descendants of classic characters.
I'm Dobie's son.
I'm Lonnie.
My mom's Mulan.
Chad, Prince Charming, Jr.
Cinderella's son.
Good.
I love that I kind of get to go back to when I was a little girl. Captivated by all the Disney fairy tales.
This place is so
gross.
I know, right? Amazingly gross. Ew.
Hey, get out of the kill zone!
While in Auradon, each of the villain kids has a life-changing experience. Jay's happens while playing a sport called tourney.
Being like on a team and being able to just run down a field and crash into people and dodge people is really, really fun.
First of all, it's like a whole new sport. Nobody's ever played it before.
Nice!
Yeah, that's it. And now you're brave.
I really hope this is a sport soon. Like an actual sport. I would play this. I'd be the first one to sign up for it.
In the middle of the field, there are cannons that shoot these things at you. You have to dodge them, and that was just really, really fun.
It's tiny for you.
You are not sending me off to some boarding school filled to the brim with prissy pink princesses.
Perfect princess.
As Jay learns teamwork on the field, Evie learns a lesson while chasing a prince.
In the beginning, finding a prince is most definitely Evie's dream. So when I get to Auradon, I have my eyes set on Prince Charming, who's Cinderella's son.
Is everybody at home as pretty as you?
I like to think I'm the fairest of them all.
But an unexpected admirer changes everything.
Hi, guys.
Doug is Dopey's son, and he's nerdy and geeky, and I have absolutely zero interest in Doug in the beginning.
Are you stalking me?
Technically, yes.
But he kind of trails after me while I'm, you know, kind of fawning over Prince Charming.
And Evie discovers who she really is.
Then Doug kind of teaches me that I'm more than just the makeup and the pretty dresses. Evie becomes a nerd in the scene. She realizes that she's like a strong, independent young girl and believes in herself for the first time. And I think that's a really beautiful story and a really beautiful evolution.
Craziness!
Carlos. They have dogs in Auradon.
Oh, no, I'm not going.
Thanks to his mom, Carlos grew up with a serious fear of dogs.
Cruella has told Carlos that dogs are evil.
Carlos?
But in Auradon, he meets Dude.
This thing is a killer!
Dude, meet Carlos.
Or as she's known on set, her dudeness, because she is a girl, but she's playing a boy.
I know you want these treats.
Befriending Dude shows Carlos that not everything his mom taught him is right.
Is that a dog?
And the dog kind of helps him open up to this whole new world that he's living in.
And what about the perfect size for evil?
He's the perfect size for a pet.
So it's definitely a big awakening for Carlos.
I'll let you boy. Peace out, dog.
Give me a beat.
With Prince Ben was a surprise.
Indeed, I happen to say I dream of you every day, but let me shout it out loud. That's okay.
Their romance is surprising because they are total opposites. Mal is such an independent spirit.
Boyfriends are overrated.
And how would you know, Mal? You've never had one.
It's because I don't need one, E.
Something that I really loved about Mal. She is very manipulative in the beginning.
I completely understand. Be careful of treats offered by kids of villains.
Until she meets Ben and sort of gets herself thinking, wow, someone actually loves me.
See that? Totally trust you.
She's never been shown affection before, and she doesn't really know how to handle it.
We don't really date much on the island. It's more gang activity.
I meant, is this your first time eating a jelly donut?
Ben's affection inspires Mal and leads to the most emotional song in Descendants.
A million thoughts in my head. Should've let my heart keep listening.
All of the musical elements were just so right, so necessary as far as like moving the story along.
While Mal and Ben get serious on screen, behind the scenes,
covered in sweat.
Duff Cameron and Mitchell Hope weren't always so serious.
My back hurts. I wonder what. Oh, it's because I'm carrying this whole scene.
Their friendship clearly translated to the screen.
And there's no question that something so beautiful is happening between the two of them. You know, the audience is going to be going like, come on, guys.
It's like father and son.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yes. You're very nerd.
That is so cute. Do it again.
Coming up.
Don't be so serious, darling.
She's the most evil of the group.
Those are so sweet.
More from the bad boys and girls of Disney Channel's Descendants.
All day, every day.
Before every take, this is how she warms up. Oh, my gosh.
Hey guys, welcome to the set of Disney.
Disney Channel's Descendants.
You're looking a little washed out. Let me help you out.
Ew, stop.
Hair and makeup is vital to Descendants. Their style perfectly sets up the characters.
Everything is spectacular. And if you could have pictured in your mind what the daughter of the Evil Queen would look like, what the daughter of Maleficent would look like, it's incredible.
Yay.
Mal is, you know, London, steampunk, a little vintage, a little futuristic as well.
There's black and green and purple, kind of like dirty candy colors.
My mom taught me how to apply blush before I could talk. Evie's the girly girl of the group, so she loves her hair and makeup. She wears a lot of blue glitter shadows.
Brings out your eyes.
I know. If I had three words to describe Evie's look, it would definitely be princessy, fabulous, edgy.
Yeah, James wardrobe style. It's fun.
There's a little hint in there of Jafar. He's dirty and he's grungy.
Hello, Foxy.
It's definitely an attention getter.
You guys look awesome today.
Thank you.
The look of Carlos is really, really cool. It's the 70s kind of punky combat boots, and he's always wearing shorts, and he just doesn't care, and he's got like fur.
I wear nothing but black and white.
And red, because those are the colors of my mother.
And he's got this going on, which is a homage to Cruella.
To my mommy.
The four villain kids wear the influence of their parents on their sleeves. Or backs, anyway. Symbols that represent their parents are on all of their costumes.
It's just stuff like that that really gives the audience like a really complete view of these characters.
I look not hideous.
Not even close.
That couldn't have been better, Sophia.
I pinch myself every morning when I wake up.
Come on over, honey. Come look.
Because I still can't believe that Kenny Ortega is my boss right now.
Oh, that's so cool.
Oh, you'll like it. You'll like it. Very good. Okay. Very good. Okay. Very good.
Kenny Ortega is the legendary director of High School Musical.
Kenny's very well known for big, splashy musical numbers, and he's an iconic choreographer.
Move her across your body. Yeah, one more time.
Every single one of his films has this deep-rooted magic in it.
And every single one of your bits in this movie right now is just like killer, over-the-top awesome.
And he's a genius.
Wow. He spends a lot of time with us, and you can tell he really cares about his actors.
Cameron!
Woo! Yeah. You know, who wouldn't want to work with Kenny Ortega? Oh.
If I guess who you're texting, can I like have $5?
No.
The Descendants cast quickly discovered that their director was also the biggest prankster on set.
She'll be looking this way, so okay. She'll have no idea that you're coming.
Oh, okay, cool. Kenny was always pulling pranks on us.
It was Cameron and Sophia and Boo Boo and Mitch just coming in to crash my really big emotional ballad. That terrified me. I was like, should I tell them there are creatures behind them? Like, running at me. I thought they were animals.
This is a momentous occasion, and one that I hope will go down in history.
Yes, Descendants is full of epic action and incredible music.
It must be magic.
But in the end, the movie is about characters we love and their personal journeys.
Mom, have you ever once asked me what I want from not you?
And I think it's a film that people will walk away from looking differently at themselves.
I hope the audience takes away the sense of just being your own person.
This dog loves me, and I love him.
I think the most important message is that no matter who you are or where you come from, at the end of the day, this is your life, and you choose to be whoever you want to be.
You don't have to be a follower. You know, you can just be an individual. That's the heart of the film.
Taking back tonight.
Yeah, we just said it all.
Break the spell. We were born this way. Be yourself, the gift, the DNA. Everybody raise your hands and say.
The four villain kids aren't just a team in the movie. The cast quickly became real life friends.
I became very close with the villain kids.
Because we're rotten.
To the core.
Four of us just have this really, really awesome chemistry, and we just bounce off of each other.
One, two, three.
It's always like the little jokes that we've all created.
Baby, and boo-boo.
Every moment behind the scenes and off camera is funny for us. There isn't a moment on set where we aren't cracking up all together. It's time to set this thing off. Let's make it happen now. We've truly become a family.
We're just trying to, like, be older brothers. The ultimate is back down,
judging me because of my background. And I've grown to really, really love my castmates. When people really like each other, it makes that much of a difference. It'll show on camera.
For me personally, the relationships were so easy to create because I love Cameron and Boo and Sophia so much.
Descendants was an unforgettable movie experience, both for fans and the stars.
I was really proud to be a part of something that is so touched by magic.
Like my beautiful one.
We've put our hearts and souls into each and every single scene in this movie.
Hi, ho.
And we're all so honored to be a part of it.
The cast had the time of their lives making the movie, and it shows.
Let's get this party started.
I hope the audience falls in love with the story as much as we have.
I hope that people just watch the movie and they just leave feeling good about themselves.
And I hope most of all that they just have fun and really, really enjoy this movie as much as we have.
Descendants was the Disney Channel movie event of the summer and the experience of a lifetime. It's full of magic and music we can relive over and over again.
Get it trending, hashtag TV.
It's gonna happen.
I'm a butterfly.
I'm so ready. I'm gonna cry again.
You're so silly.
You're ready to set it off? I'm ready to set it off. Let's set it off.